Greetings. More reasons to reject Islam. Reason 3. Fundamentally, Islam is racist. Islam stands on the racism that Arabs are the best people in the world. Dang, Texas. Hold your horses. How can you possibly say that? Well, let's step back from the edge and talk about it. Boil it all down, and Islam assumes only Arabs can be trusted to preserve the word of Allah. Well, let's again slow down and examine the story of Islam to see how I come to this conclusion. Islam, or the Quran, claims that Allah sent prophets and messages to every nation. Surah 10:47, and for every nation there is a messenger. Surah 35:24, and there is not a people but a warner has gone among them. And those prophets all brought messages, meaning scriptures, with them. Surah 35:25, and if they belie you, those before them also belied. Their messengers came to them with clear signs, and with the scriptures and the book giving light. So looking at Muhammad's Quran, he claims that every nation, every tribe, every race has had their own scriptures, their own message from Allah. And yet somehow, the only group, only nation, only tribe, only race to follow Allah and keep His message are the Arabs. And the only scripture the Arabs consider correct is the Arabic Quran. That means every other scripture has been corrupted by the nation it was sent to. Ignore for the moment there is no manuscript evidence to support Islam's fantasy. Every nation, every tribe, every race that Allah sent His message to corrupted it, lost it, did not preserve it. Only the Arabs, historically renowned for their memorization skills and their truthfulness, their integrity and their peacefulness, their steadfastness and their discipline, only the Arabs kept the word of Allah without changing a single character. Only the Arabs have the commitment to Allah to give up even freedom to obey their Allah. After all, one must give up freedom to be disciplined and enslaved. And it is not like knowing the truth is supposed to set you free. Oh, wait, John 8:32, then you will know the truth, and the truth will set you free. This was spoken by Prophet Jesus. It is part of the true Injil. But evidently, Prophet Jesus did not know the message of Allah is to conquer and enslave. Evidently, Prophet Jesus was confused and an unbeliever of the true message of Allah, like this good Muslim is. No other nation on earth, no other race on earth, not the Incas, nor the Mayans, not the Greeks, nor the Romans, not the Japanese, nor the Chinese, not the Africans, nor the Egyptians, not even the Jews who received all the prophets, not even the Jews who witnessed all the miracles of Moses. No, sir. If Muhammad is to be believed, Arabs, and only Arabs, have any regard or respect for Almighty God. No other tribe or nation or race of people has ever preserved the message that Allah sent to them. Only the Arabs. And this arrogant racism feeds into their claim the Quran is only the Quran when it is in the original Arabic. And the Quran backs up this opinion. Surah 3, 110. You are the best of peoples, evolved for mankind, enjoining what is right, forbidding what is wrong, and believing in Allah. If only the people of the book had faith, it were best for them. Among them are some who have faith, but most of them are perverted transgressors. Wow! Right there, proof from Allah's own lips. Arabs were evolved for mankind. Remember when Muhammad wrote the Quran, he was only talking to Arabs. Sort of like Jesus, the prophet of Deuteronomy 18, being sent to the lost sheep of Israel. Sure, the seeds of global conquest and domination were planted with the goal of enslaving all of humanity to Muhammad's religion, but it was up to the Arabs to carry the torch. But is it a mystery that Islam is racist, and that Islam tries to elevate the Arabs over the Jews? It should not be, because Islam's jealousy goes all the way back to Ishmael's jealousy of Isaac. And it really makes sense that an Arab man would create his religion to praise Arabs and revile Jews. The fascinating thing to me is that so few people ever spend time thinking about such historical foundations. If they did, they could easily see just how racist Islam truly is. But the world would rather hate the Jews than think clearly about such matters. So in the last days, it will be very easy to seduce the world into Islam. Think about it. To prove my point another way, take a moment and try to find any examples from Islam making racist statements about any other race beside the Jews. The Swedes, the Spaniards, the French. I mean, everybody hates the French, right? Just kidding. No, the Quran is very pointed and specific and speaks directly with its venom for the Jews. The Quran is racist. And don't bother with your vapid, self-serving claims that Zionism is racism. If you haven't looked, the whole Zionism is racism crap was created and pushed by Mohammedans. Zion belongs to Zionists, and did for 1,000 years before Muhammad. So I think Islam's inherent racism is a good reason to reject Islam forever. You do not have to remain in slavery to Mohammedism. Understand, I have no interest in trying to be politically correct. The truth will always offend those who have an agenda that runs in opposition to the truth. If you call yourself Muslim, it is not too late to repent and return to the true Injil, the message Jesus brought. If calling your pagan cult Mohammedism offends you, grow up and get past it. Either you have a desire, however deep down and suppressed, to value the truth, or you really have no unction to seek God and the truth, and you choose your fate in ignorance. The choice is up to you, O Muslim. Will you stop and listen to the voice inside you that tells you the evil Islam commits is not right? Or will you allow your programmed reflex to flinch when you hear the words Mohammedan, begotten, Son of God? Find a copy of the Bible and begin to read it, O Muslim. Treat the Bible the way you treat the Quran, just as Surah 2:136 commands you. Show God respect, brother, and God will open your heart to the true path He revealed by His prophets. May the Spirit of God open your eyes to the light, your ears to the truth, and your heart to His Son, the Lord Jesus Christ. And may God deliver you from the racist evil that is called Islam before it is too late. Amen.